Well, a couple of things. I think they should consider Spencer Dinwiddie.
Okay.
I think that's somebody that they should consider. He can ball. He's coming off an injured season. Remember, he only played 3 games last year, but the year before, he averaged 20-6. Mm-hmm. We can't forget that. He can ball, and obviously he's looking for a better situation than he would have in Brooklyn because the big three is there. Secondly, do not give, and I don't like messing with people's money. I truly, truly do not. I want everybody to get paid.
Yep.
But Julius Randle is not a number one option.
Okay.
You want to give him a max, but it can't be an exorbitant max. The max now at about 106 to 110, that's where he got to be. About 25, 28 million a year, mm-hmm. That's about right, okay? So let's make sure we do that. Outside of that, all you can do is pray, man. I mean, listen. Mitchell Robinson's coming back.
You don't want to win
the match. Listen, Mitchell Robinson is going to be back. You got to re-up him. You got to re-up Julius Randle. If you can pull it off, you go out there and you get somebody like a Spencer Dinwiddie. You retain Derrick Rose.
Yeah, okay.
You retain Derrick Rose. And the only way you throw everything out is if Damian Lillard says, I want out of Portland, because I'm here to tell you.
Mm-hmm.
If Damian Lillard wants out of Portland, and I'm not sure he does yet, his number one choice is going to be the New York Knicks.
Ooh, really?
Heard it right here.
Ooh, inside scoop.
His number one choice is going to be the New York Knicks.
Mm.
Now, not over Portland. He's trying to stay there if it can work out. But if he decides to leave, I'm betting the house. Ooh. It's the New York Knicks that he'll want to go to. Now, if you're the New York Knicks.
Couple houses.
Where's the camera?
Steve, there you go.
Leon Rose. Worldwide West, William Wesley. Scott Perry. Tom Thibodeau. I don't want to hear cap space and picks. You give Portland what the hell they asked for if Damian Lillard is available to come. And I don't know if he's going to do that. I don't know if he's going to demand that. I don't know if Neil O'Shea is going to capitulate.
Right.
But if that possibility is there, Leon Rose, Worldwide West, Scott Perry, Tom Thibodeau, you do what you got to do to get Damian.
Well, I'm going
to
ask you one question about, though, because your New York Knicks gave up a lot of the farm for Carmelo Anthony, when it's possible they could have gotten him down the road in free agency, but they wanted to make sure they got him, and they gave up assets for him, and it made it a little harder for them and Melo to win.
Yep. Right.
So do you think that they should do the same if a Damian Lillard deal
But remember one of the problems that they existed, they didn't have the cap space.
Yes.
So it was picks with no cap space.
Yes.
You got cap space now. You just be giving up some picks. Well, what the hell are you giving up picks for? To compete.
Yep.
And so here you are on the first round.
You want them to give up players, too.
And LeBron and Miami and them were in the Eastern Conference. You had Melo. Amari couldn't be healthy.
Yep.
You know, so that's what happened. This particular situation, you're going to have to give up a lot to get a Damian Lillard if it comes to that, and I'm not sure it will. But, my Lord, at 31, 32 years of age, the closing ability, nobody has hit more clutch shots. A point guard who can shoot like that in today's NBA game at Madison Square Garden. No, you do that. You do that.
Well, I don't want to take you off the Damian Lillard train, but I have to say, assuming that doesn't happen today.
No, it's not going to happen.
Or in the next couple days. What do you think about him saying, don't give the farm to Julius Randle?
Dame time in the garden could be incredible.
It's hard to not think about that.
You know what's weird to me? I like Julius Randle. I agree. I think he's a great A-minus, maybe second option.
And
that's with all due respect. What's crazy to me is, you know, this team hasn't been very good for such a long time. And in previous years, you always hear a bunch of people, okay, we're going to go to the Knicks. Now that they've actually made the playoffs and starting to head in the right direction with Tom Thibodeau, you don't hear any stars trying to get to New York. So that's kind of interesting to me. But I think this may be a situation where they're going to have to get second tier free agents, you know, the second wave of free agents of Spencer Dinwiddie, some of these guys, and build with small pieces and continue to compete until maybe something happens where a superstar does want to come. So I don't really see a superstar making that jump outside of Dame. You know, Stephen A's betting all his houses on it. But outside of that, like I said, I think it's going to be small pieces here and there, nothing that's really going to, you know, make a huge splash, but small pieces continue to get better until one moment where they can go get a superstar.
We 100% agree. That's what I'm saying.
Yeah.
Do those things.
Yeah, but you're just saying
I'm not saying Damian Lillard's going to want to leave Portland.
But
if he wants to leave Portland, it's going to be the Knicks. And by the way, who ain't coming to New York to play with Damian Lillard?
I mean,
who ain't coming to New York to play with Damian Lillard? I ain't going to mention any names yet. But let me tell you something. I got about 5 of them.
Mm-hmm.
Who ain't going to come to New York to play with Damian Lillard?
It'll take that one domino, though.
Yeah. I'm getting a little sweaty right now because I'm getting all excited. Just, oh, my Lord. Oh.
So can you feel, Stephen A., all the way from Houston, just this mayor possibility of maybe sort of possibly?
Hey, Perk, that shirt brings your eyes out, by the way.
Well, Rachel, look, I had...
Yeah, those eyebrows. Yeah,
I appreciate it, man.
You know, let the man talk about basketball.
Well, actually
it's true, man. It's true.
Look. I'm telling you. Listen to this though. Damian Lillard to the Knicks helped the Knicks and the New York Knicks fan base, but it don't help Damian Lillard. Damian Lillard should be trying to go somewhere that could help him actually win a title. Now, Damian Lillard in Madison Square Garden, I agree, Stephen A. and Max, is must-see TV. But when you talk about the New York Knicks, right, you got Julius Randle, you have Derrick Rose, you have R.J. Barrett, and I agree with your point, Stephen A., add a Spencer Dinwiddie, or maybe add a DeMar DeRozan to the mix. You continue to have your player development. Mm-hmm. You go get a Spencer Dinwiddie, a guy that actually could play off the ball, that you could play alongside Derrick Rose because he's a big guard, right? So he's a combo guard that can space the floor. He's great moving off the ball. He's a great defender, so he fits the culture of the New York Knicks. I just don't know if I'm in the front office of the New York Knicks, I give up so much to get Dame Lillard. And then what if you don't hit a home run and attract more superstars? Now you done gave up a lot of your young pieces to get Dame Lillard when he's standing in Madison Square Garden himself with just you and Spike Lee.
Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.